Hello guys, this is Nissan Versa Sedan 1.6 2012-13, old Nissan probably. Same, I'm doing the roots. As you see, my car was vibrating and I know it's a router. Just got the new routers and line cheap. I did the pad last year, but still the roots not good. Somehow was sitting, maybe before I bought it. To do that, you know, secure your jack stands, and then this four bolt as is a 21 millimeter. You can open like you lose it before you use your power with something like this wrench, and then your caliper should be number 14, but I try to do with the 916. My set doesn't have 14. So need to open these two, one there, and then one right here. If you don't have 14, it should be 916. These two, one in here, one in here. Once you open your caliper, you can see right now, it should move a little bit, but you gotta use some power. Because I painted before, probably. And other than that, there is a two number 17. You need number 17 for the roots. This one here. There is one here and one down. Sometimes they are seized. I had a hard time to open, but you know, it opens. So you be careful, put some W40 or something not to damage the head. Once you open, there is one you can see. One in here on top. Let me take it out so you can see. Okay, so there is one 17 there. See, it's moving now. And there is one 17 on the bottom. Still a little bit stuck. I don't want to make this video like long. Just pretty much every rotors are same stuff. This is for the rotor. If I was doing my pad, then I don't need to open this. This number 14. But I'm doing my rotors. Once you open this thing, you gotta hang your caliper nicely with a zip tie, something in case of the brake line, and it can break or damage. Especially I'm doing outside New Heat Garage. Just bear with me a few seconds. So this is the second bolt, number 17. So some car mostly 17, some car could be 19. These two are, if you open the rotor, as you see my calipers already, I opened these two small ones, 14, one in here, one here. The 17 is for the rotor. Once this comes out, put it somewhere nicely. I see my pad is almost 90% good. So you need to hammer this a little bit. But I'm just gonna put it here for now. Gonna go get the hammer to take this rotor out of here. It's seized. It's not gonna come out easy, but I do need it anyway. So just to tell you guys, this is a caliper. We took it out. You need to tap this rotor. Once it's come out, you put your new rotors, clean it. And then if your pad's okay, if not, you need to have the things to push it out. Put it back together. For doing this, you don't need to bleed air unless you have issue before, unless you change in your color, your calipers. For pads and rotors, you don't need to bleed air. Thank you.